What's up, Smashers? Good morning. Father's Day today. I'm going to be doing some Achilles tendonitis. Hey, I'm going to run in on this. You got to check this out. These guys are doing the 1775 workout today. That's Matt, Coach, Lynn, owner, two badass athletes. There they go. It's awful. It's an hour. In case you didn't know, that's JT. The most lethal man alive, and you'd never know. So badass. Hey, so we're gonna be doing Achilles tendonitis. Some big problems, because a lot of times we're gonna change the word from itis to osis. And here's why. Because what happens is, a lot of times people look at the, by the way, good morning. A lot of times what people do is they look at an injury, whether it's a bicep issue, whether it's a forearm issue, whether it's an Achilles issue, and immediately when it starts to get inflamed, it starts to hurt, they automatically call it tendonitis. You go to a doctor, doctor hits you up, says it's tendonitis, they start bombing you with NSAIDs, and none of that works, but the problem is they don't address the injury right at the beginning. So here's a really, really easy way to remember. If you've had the injury for a little while and it's still inflamed, still hurts, old and cold, right? That means it's tendinosis, not tendonitis. That means the tissue's, the inflammation is pretty much gone, and now it's pain. And that tissue's really lost a lot of its elasticity. The tendons aren't working right. The sliding surfaces are gone. We need to take that and peel it apart and get it working the way it's supposed to. So once that tendon starts working, we can restore blood flow. We can restore water content to the tendon. We can reduce any of the congestion and the sticky ickiness in there and all that gnarly tack down garbage, and free up the mobility of the joint that's below it. But we have to address upstream and downstream too. So first thing is, when we're looking at the ankle, you want to check what's called capsular mobility. And that's just the function of the capsule. Remember, there's 26 bones in the human foot. And that's a big deal, because all those bones, every time you take a step, have to adapt to the terrain. And if they can't, that's because the mechanics are off. So what I'm going to show you is, check this out. There's such an easy way to check if you have full range of ankle motion. If you don't, you can't do this. So you're just going to grab. All you're going to do, if you look, feet are flat, right? Get your feet together and just drop into a squat. If you can drop into a squat with flat feet, if your heels aren't popping up off the ground, then you have full ankle range of motion. It's just that easy. You wanna make it a little more complicated, toss a pistol in there. But that's really important. So right off the bat, let's say you have full ankle range of motion. Sorry, I'm getting comfortable. You have full ankle range of motion, and what happens then, it's not an ankle range of motion, it's not a capsular issue. If it is a capsular issue, I'm gonna show you how to peel that away as well. So we're gonna hit both sides, because the problem is, if I'm just doing a tendon issue, there's gonna be a lot of questions about what if it's a capsule issue. So I'm gonna do both. How's that? So first thing you wanna do is, you wanna look at the way the Achilles is glued to the back of that tibia, and the way it's sticking to the tissue and glued to that calcaneus, and we wanna peel that away. So we wanna check the back, and if you have a lot of tenderness, yeah, right, because you can see that right through my magic. So if you have a lot of tenderness up through here, down in through here, right where it attaches to the calcaneus, then there's a good chance that that tendon's not sliding the way it's supposed to. So the first thing you wanna do is restore that sliding surface. You're gonna grab your voodoo band. This thing is gold. So we're gonna hit that voodoo band. Remember, 50% tension, 50% overlap. So I'm gonna wrap myself up right now in this thing real quick. We're just gonna trap this tendon. The big thing is, when you're trapping this, you wanna really load this tissue up. Now, I'm gonna load this a little light, just because I'm probably gonna be wearing this for about the next 5 minutes while I'm talking to you guys. But you wanna trap as much of that as possible. And the cool thing about a voodoo band is, you end up capturing the front and the back. So you're getting that tibialis anterior too. So just to give you an idea, tibialis anterior runs down the front here, okay? That's the tibialis anterior. And then you're hitting that Achilles in the back here as well. So you're tacking down all that tissue. So what you're gonna do is, you can see right now, sleeve of a barbell. You can use anything you want. Don't you love that this thing is pink, by the way? So badass. So what you wanna do is, you wanna get your foot on the sleeve of the barbell. You get as close to that bone as possible. Take your other foot, cross it over, add some weight, and start doing circles, okay? When that becomes loosened up, cross over, work your way, oh, this one's grizzly. Work your way all the way up. You're gonna take this, you're gonna go all the way up. Good. All the way. Like, that's so stuck. And you're going to find some hot spots. What I want you to do is 10 circles counterclockwise, 10 circles clockwise. It's a big old funky hair on me. That's just nasty. So you're going to take this and you're going to tack all this down, unglue all this. Okay, you want to free up all that tissue. But before we take the voodoo band off, what we're going to do is you're going to hit the anterior side too. So we're going to hit that tibialis anterior right through here. So what you're going to do is just take, this is a solid piece of PVC. I don't want you using a rumble roller. It's too soft. And all you're going to do is take your, let me back up just a little bit so you can see what I'm doing. All you're going to do is you're going to take your shin and you're just going to grind away all along the outside of this, all over where that, oh, where that voodoo band is. So basically I'm taking that tibialis anterior, I'm pointing this toe under here so I can put a little stretch on this, and I'm just ripping this apart, peeling it right off the bone. That's number two. Remember, we're addressing upstream and the anterior side of that joint as well. So that's number two, okay? You wanna take this off? I'm gonna take it off because it friggin' hurts. I love the sounds in this gym, by the way. So badass. And what we're doing right now is we're making an Achilles problem your bitch. That's how it works. Now you're gonna take this. So, lacrosse ball, we wanna hit the bottom of the foot. There's a lot of stuff involved here, but I promise you, this is really important. You're gonna take the lacrosse ball, you're just gonna take your foot. So you can see what I'm doing right here. Let me back up just a little bit. I know, killer cameraman skills. Look, I got a lot of donuts in me right now. So you're gonna take your foot, and I want you to take the ball and just go ahead and smash away on the bottom of the foot. It's so important, but get some weight on it. So right now, I'm giving my knee a big hug, and I am just grinding. Holy crap, that's terrible. Make sure your toes are flared out. So give your knee a big hug, we love ourselves. And then you're just gonna flare out the toes and you're gonna grind away on all this tissue until you feel the bottom of that foot change, because that's gonna free up that arch as well. You're gonna deload that Achilles. That's number three. I know we got lots of stuff, okay? Now there's one more aspect to this, and that is high hip mechanics and quad mechanics. The problem is we get on this stuff and these are gonna have a direct influence on that ankle because they're gonna transfer all that power through the knee. So if the hip isn't working right, you need to address that as well. So right now we've already peeled off that that Achilles tendon, restored some blood flow. We've hit that tibialis anterior, we've hit that calf on the back, and now we've hit the bottom of the foot, all that plantar tissue. Take this, so easy. I know I'm doing this all around a barbell, but you're just gonna do two things. Number one, you're just gonna lay over the PVC, not in the groin. So right now you can see what I have, right? So I am just gonna find that hot spot, usually the vastus lateralis, the outside of the leg, and I'm just gonna kick back and forth. So all I'm doing is I'm grinding away that tissue until I feel it change, then I'm gonna move higher up in the hip. Same thing, I wanna work my way all the way down to just above the knee. But you know what? Stay off the knee, okay? It hurts. So grinding away, all the way, you're gonna roll on the outside, roll on the inside, basically you're tacking down that entire quadriceps complex and ripping it off the bone to unload that hip. There's the last one we're gonna do though. Super easy, you guys understand this stuff. Mega super secret stretch. Okay, you guys have probably never seen this before. The couch stretch, check this out. So we're gonna open up the iliacus and the rectus femoris and the psoas, peel that open so you don't have a muted pelvis, you can open them up. So, by the way, I'm not swatting at the air, there's a fly. And all you're gonna do, it's hot today, and all you're gonna do is make sure this foot is tucked in all the way against the wall, squeeze your glutes, bring yourself all the way back, hang out like this for how long? 2 minutes, baby. Just stand here and hang out. Squeeze it, feel this peeling away, opening up the hips. That's how you unload that Achilles problem. Remember, tendonitis is gonna be an issue that just happened, an acute injury, something that just happened, tissue super inflamed, hit it with some ice, hit it with some heat, loosen it up. Tendinosis is gonna be long standing, 6, 7, 8, 10 weeks. I've had people 8, 10, 12 months. Remember, old and cold, that's when you do all this stuff. Free up that tissue, get that blood flow working. I'm Trev, Father's Day, happy Father's Day to all you dads out there. I think you guys are awesome. I'll see you guys tomorrow, have a great day.